Hello everyone. Today we're going to demonstrate for you one of the most powerful features offered by Simplicity for the reusing of components in your Simplicity project. This concept is called substitution, and it allows you to define attributes in the case of classes and objects in Simplicity, or variables at the screen and graphic level that you are then able to reuse within your expressions and class definition to be able to substitute in dynamically values at runtime or at object creation time, allowing you to define things once and reuse them multiple times. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to use a demo project that simulates a part production factory. So in this part production factory or project, we have created a Simplicity class called heat exchanger, T heat exchanger defines the attributes and data items of an actual heat exchanger being talked to by a PLC. When working with classes in Simplicity, you typically define a number of data items that retrieve actual data from an edge device like a PLC. So we're going to do that today. I've already defined a number of these data items that are in the PLC and retrieving values, and we're going to together create a new data item. We'll call it ambient, and it's going to be a device point. And we're going to go out to our PLC, which we've already defined to the connection information. And we're going to browse to that PLC. And if you look in the PLC, you can see we have two heat exchangers that it's gathering data from. So typically, you would just go out and browse for that value, and it would put the address of that value here in the node ID field for this OPC UA client device, and we would be able to get that direct value. However, since there's two heat exchangers, we want to be able to reuse this class and create an instance of the heat exchanger 1234 and another instance of heat exchanger 2345, but we don't want to have to come in and try to modify the address of the points we're retrieving to get the specific instance values. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the concept of attributes. At a class level, you're able to define an attribute that will be available on object creation to give a unique value to. So in this case, I've created a heat exchanger number attribute, and its default value is 1234, but that will be specific to an instance we create. So let me demonstrate that. So I've got the HE number, and I can use that attribute in my definitions throughout my class definition. So as we just showed, we have a 1234 here, but we want that to be dynamically substituted as we create objects. So I'm going to put instead HE number, the heat exchanger number, inside of curly braces here, and this becomes a substitutable value. We'll find this and change it to the actual value of the instanced version of this asset. So I put that in the definition here, and then if we look at our object list, I've already created a heat exchanger 1234. Now I'm going to create the heat exchanger 2345. And what that does is it gives me now an option to set the actual values of those attributes for this specific instance. So we don't want 1234 here, we want 2345, because that's a different instance. So if I do that, and I take a look at what it created for those data items, here's that ambient temperature. You can see, whereas before we had curly brace HE number, it's substituted in that value 2345 of the specific value we gave to this instance. And you can see that through all of these data items have used that same attribute. So that's been properly substituted, and now we'll be retrieving values from that specific instance. If you look at the heat exchanger 1234, of course its values have substituted 1234 instead. So that's a powerful ability to define an asset information once and in a class and reuse it as we create instances. So that's the concept of attributes.